Gabriel of Urantia is a spiritual leader, musician, author, visionary, and co-founder of Global Community Communications Alliance, a multifaceted world spiritual community and eco-village. Conversations with Activists to Inspire Global Change provides a forum for activists to voice their concern for humanitarian issues. Thomas Mapfumo is called the Lion of Zimbabwe for his courageous stand against the oppressive government of Zimbabwe. His music speaks to this oppression and the cause of his people.
Thomas, I feel like a kindred spirit with you. I've listened to your music, and unfortunately, I've just heard of you in the last couple months.
Okay.
You probably have never heard of me until now.
Oh, yeah.
And I think there's a reason for that,
mm-hmm.
and that's why I feel kindred spirit with you. I feel that the more that you have to say the truth in music, the more your lyrics represent the truth about life, about reality in your country, my country,
sure.
The problems of the world, the more that music is really suppressed.
Sure.
By the governments, by the music industry, the main music industry.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, briefly, what happened to me was after I wrote the freedom song for the Nigerian
mm-hmm.
freedom fighter Ken Sarawiwa,
okay.
A major network, NBC Dateline, basically came after me,
mm-hmm.
misrepresented themselves and a show that they wanted to do with me and my community.
Mm-hmm.
And then for 1 hour on national television,
mm-hmm.
Lambasted my character and so on, et cetera. And VH1 did the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And so did Entertainment Tonight.
No.
And these are major, millions and millions of people saw this. And I'm still suffering
okay.
from that misrepresentation.
Mm-hmm.
And I do see the problems of the world, the injustices, and I do try to write about them. And
that's right.
I'd just like to ask you, what's been your experience in that area with major music labels, or have you felt the same kind of oppression there?
Yeah, that is very true. It's like right now, I'm an independent artist. I do my own things back home. I have my own recording company, which is Chimurenga Music Company. And that was after I actually experienced some very difficult times with major labels. I was working with this other label, the Mango label, that's part of the Island Records. Well, it's like I never got any cent out of all the music that they actually sold. And the same thing is also happening in Harare, where Grama Records is the only record company that is able to distribute, people's music. But also, they are actually exploiting a lot of youngsters, and it's not working. So this is the reason why, one has to maybe think and say, oh, well, I have to take my own way, I have to do my own things, and things like that.
I know you wrote Corruption. Can you share any of the lyrics of Corruption?
Yeah. I wrote this song after I actually noticed a lot of corruption within our government. There were a lot of corrupt individuals in that government, and still there. And this is what actually inspired me to write this song. Well, it's like some of the lyrics that say sex for a job. That is what is happening today. Women go out there to look for jobs, and they are told, if you can't have sex with me, you will get no job. And things like that, and people do a lot of things, corrupt things, and as you know, that song actually didn't, I mean, please the government officials, because they knew very well what I meant, and the message with, I mean, within the lyrics touched them very, very much, and they decided to not to play that music on the radio. So that's one of those things. I wasn't worried about that, because I am a freedom fighter, and that is what I do. And I work for the people, so I'm not afraid for my life. I'm not afraid for my music to be banned from the radio. That is okay with me.
Mm-hmm. Chimurenga means struggle.
Struggle.
Can you explain that? Is that a, how would you explain the struggle?
Well, this music, I named it, I mean, Chimurenga, because of when I started writing this type of music, that's when the liberation war broke out in our country, and I decided to name the music Chimurenga, because of, I mean, the liberation struggle. But this name was, Chimurenga was there before me, because those who fought in the first Chimurenga, like Mbuyanihanda and Kagubi and Chaminuka, those are some of our heroes. They were, I mean, killed in that war. So I decided to actually name the music Chimurenga, because the music played a very important role during the liberation struggle, and I thought the music, I mean, deserved to be named, I mean, Chimurenga.
To me, the word, when I hear the word struggle, I think of the oppression of all the poor people of the planet, all the indigenous peoples, the wealth of the world. Mm-hmm. Is owned and controlled by just a few families.
Sure, that's, you know, very true.
And the majority of the world struggles for bare existence, to keep a roof over their head.
That's very true.
Etc. In our community, we have a word called divine administration, which are principles that we tried to follow, of equality for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have no private property, and everybody gives what they can, and we distribute that the best way we can across the community.
That's right.
Right now we have around 80 adults and 20, 21 children,
mm-hmm.
and we're growing. We've been together for 12 years, and this is why this future studios here, this is possible, because no one person made it possible. It's a joint effort of a lot of people, and I see that as what the world needs to join together. And I think that a lot of nationalism, for instance, doesn't work because we need to come to a consciousness of your child is my child, my child is yours.
That's very true.
When your child hurts, my child hurts.
Yeah, that's very true.
And so until we get to that consciousness level, and get away from nationalism, we're going to continue to separate ourselves by titles, religions.
We are singing about evil people that we read in the news today. There are a lot of people who deny other people their freedom. The freedom of speech, freedom of movement, and we call such people oppressors. They oppressed the poor people. So when such people actually die, the whole world rejoices. Thank you. Thank you.
Ndakaona wata richifamba ndakazoti ndawana mukaranga mai. Ndakazoti nanyakukutarisa ndakaona inga richiwata wata.
Live in fear. They are harassed. They face all the difficulties that this earth today is facing. Those issues are not being addressed by any top government officials. They don't like to hear about that. They know that the poor people are suffering, and they've been suffering for the rest of their lives, but they end doing nothing about that. It's not a one-sided issue. We're talking of the whole wide world. Mm-hmm. Yes.
What are some of the other songs that you've written that you feel that you'd like the American public to know about?
There are a lot of songs that I like. I mean, my latest music, the Chimurenga Rebel, where there is a lot of political messages. We have a song which says the youth don't have no jobs, they don't work. And what do they do if they don't work? They go out there in the street and cause a lot of havoc. They steal from the people, they break into cars, they do all sorts of things because they don't have jobs. If they had jobs, they wouldn't be doing that. Yes.
In Nigeria, Shell Oil was responsible for trying to take the land off the Ogoni people, and that's why Ken Saro-Wiwa spoke out, and others. Are there problems in Zimbabwe with oil companies?
Oh yeah,
there is.
There is. Mm-hmm. There is, because there have been a lot of shortages in our country. Like there was no petrol. You remember, I don't know whether you heard about that. Last time we were struggling to get petrol, oil, and things like that. Right now it's like, everything is now, there's a lot of shortages like food, petrol, sugar, things like that. Well, the country is just in chaos. It's just in chaos, and they can't believe it, because Zimbabwe was a bread basket on its own. But now today, they are they've turned themselves into beggars. Yes.
President Robert Mugabe. What do you think the people need to do to... Do you think he needs removed from office?
Well, they have to demonstrate. To do that, they have to demonstrate. Get everyone on the street and show solidarity that the people don't want him anymore. Because like what he did, during the last elections, that shows he doesn't want to let go of power. He rigged those elections. Everybody knows. The world knows.
I guess people are afraid. I guess a lot of people become afraid to do that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage to do that. It takes a lot of courage because you need to do that. You know, these things, they do happen. Yeah, remember the situation in Kosovo? People went out in the street and started demonstrating against the leadership.
I absolutely believe that we need to speak out and have freedom of speech, and we need to, it takes courage to voice our opinions because of the reprisal, the fear of reprisal. And once again, as a musician, and a writer myself and a poet mm-hmm. all my life, I feel a true poet needs to speak for the people.
Yeah, that's very true. Know?
And that's why I wrote a song for Ken Sarah Weaver, because his poetry was proactive in his stance against corruption. The world, you know, again, seems separated in so many ways. Do you have any answers that you'd like to share? Maybe how we can become a one planetary family?
I think so. From my own opinion, I think the world should be a place where everyone is free to live. Yes.
I like that.
Yes.
No immigration.
Yeah.
That would be good.
No mustn't be told what to do or where to stay. They should, be free to stay wherever they want to stay. Mm. They should have the freedom of movement, freedom of speech. They should be free in every aspect. Like you see today, we said the world is upside down. You see wars going on in the Middle East. You see problems in Zimbabwe, problems in Congo, problems in other countries all over the world. So these problems, they are supposed to be solved by us. Mm. Because you cannot put out fire by fire. Mm-hmm. You cannot do that.
Right.
You have to use water if you want to put out fire. And that is very true. Mm. Yes. Yes.
Well, some of, unfortunately, our leaders, again, are from rich, powerful families, and I don't think their major concerns are...
They're not concerned. You know. They're not concerned. We see them by the TV when they speak to the nation, they pretend to be good leaders. They pretend to be leaders of the people, but they are not. They are not, because look at the rate of the killing of what is going on today. Mm-hmm. People are dying in thousands. So this alone that shows that the world is not united. There is a lot of conflicts in this world, mm-hmm. and who is supposed to resolve all those conflicts? It's us. Because we are the humans, and we have five senses, and really we have, to come up to our senses and realize that what we are doing, we are wasting a lot of time, because we haven't got a long time on earth. My time shall come, and I'll depart from this earth. And whatever we are fighting for, we are fighting for material. Yes. What happens with material when you die? You leave it behind. Yes. That's what happens. So this land doesn't belong to any one of us. It's for every one of us. Those, we are here today, and tomorrow we will not be here. There will be other generations, to fill those gaps. So we are not here forever and ever. We have to realize that. You have to use this time to do good things. You cannot work against God. That is not so. You cannot do that, and you can't win the war. You cannot win. You fight against God, then you know very well that you'll be at the losing end.
Corporations, once again, the big corporations, corporate control, which they make billions of dollars. The average individual who's working for them, they may make, at the most, maybe $100,000 a year. Mm-hmm. That's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money.
If they make that much. But usually those that make that much are executives.
Mm-hmm.
And some make more, but the average worker, they're just, again, even here in America, trying to keep a roof over their head, and gasoline in the car, and food on the table for their children. In order to do that today here in America, a lot of those families, the wife has to be working now, mm-hmm. maybe the husband two jobs, and they're still it's difficult because mm-hmm. of the inflation
that's
happening. And now what's happening in the world trade, mm-hmm. NAFTA and so on, where they're using the labor over the world, mm-hmm. paying them 10, 20 cents an hour to do labor, and then selling those products back in America for, mm-hmm. for a pair of tennis shoes, $150, you know, and it only costs the $2 to make or less. Have you thought about what we can do about that situation?
And there are a lot of people who would like, you know, to cling on to power and cause a lot of problems. This is what is happening in this world. Talk of the American government, you hear a lot of people complaining about their foreign policies, things like that. We all read, I mean, the news and see a lot of disturbing issues. Yes, we know very well that the Israelis have their rights, I mean, to defend their own land or to defend their people. And also at the same time, if you look at the situation, it's like we are supporting the Israelis just for the sake of supporting them. We are not looking at the damage that they are doing, how many people they are killing, who is occupying whose land. That's the question we have to ask ourselves. If Israel would just move out of the West Bank and move all those settlers out of the Palestinian land, then there won't be any conflicts, and that would be the end of those conflicts. This is how we see it. We have such people, such leaders who advocate for war. Be very careful with those leaders. They are not here. They are not, the leaders for the people. They want to destroy the world. Those who advocate for war, they want to destroy the world. They don't want to the world to unite. We are as one in the face of God. But some people try and, you know, be bigger than God. That is the same thing that is happening in Zimbabwe today. Mugabe is acting like he's bigger than God. Yes. So those would be very careful of such leaders. They want to cause a lot of confusion in this world. They want to create useless wars so that they can cling on to power, which is very, very wrong. That is wrong.
One of my solutions that I've been telling people for years whenever I've gotten an opportunity on television, and of course they edit it out, the big networks edit out mm-hmm. what I say, but they're not going to edit this out because we're producing this one, but the trick again is we got to try and get this heard. But one of my solutions is that everyone in the world who believes in God, mm-hmm. no matter what you call God, mm-hmm. the Creator, should go on strike.
That's right.
The soldiers,
yeah, sure.
Everybody should go on strike until those corporations change.
Yeah, that's very true.
And they should pray and ask God where they go next. If their presidents of their corporations don't change their policies, then they should get another job.
That's very true.
You know, and have enough courage to trust God that God will supply their needs.
Mm-hmm.
That would change the world overnight, except you have to get enough people to do that. You know?
Sure, sure. Because this is, this is a struggle. We are struggling, and to overcome it, we have to be united, fight together until victory is achieved.
Because, you know, no matter what country you go to, I'm sure you'll find we're all the same.
Yeah, oh yeah.
You know, goodness in people, the same goodness in your heart,
oh yeah,
is the same goodness in my
That's
heart.
That's very
know?
True.
And that doesn't change worldwide.
No.
We are brothers and sisters, no matter what color, no matter what religion, and we have to find what unites us.
That is very important. You
know, and treasure that, and be willing to die for it if necessary. But we do need to speak out, and I encourage all Americans. I encourage people from all over the world to speak out against injustice, and of course to go on strike. And until that happens, it's just going to continue.
Because
people support the fallen system. Mm-hmm. You know, that fallen system is in Zimbabwe, it's in Nigeria, South Africa, all over the world. And as long as people have shutters on their eyes, you know, they'll continue to, you know, to listen to what they're telling you on television.
Okay.
And then, and those commentators on television are owned and operated by the executives at the top. They only say what they're told to say.
They only say what they are told to do, to say, you know.
And so how is the truth going to get out there?
No.
So we're trying. So if this gets out there, you know that something's happened. That got it out there, that some executive at the top at some level decided to do something right for a change, you know. And that's why it got out there, to the level in which we like it to get out there, all over the world by satellite. And that's what this is about. And so if this gets out there and you see this happening right now, we ask you to support our nonprofit organization, to go on strike, to trust God for your needs, to not have misplaced loyalties against corporations or governments. God should be the first loyalty. If God is in your heart the way it's supposed to be, that next direction, that next step, that next move, you'll know what it is, and you should follow it, because that's what Thomas Mapfumo has done all his life, I believe, that's led him to, you know, a freedom fighter stance in his music and mine in my music. And because you can't let record labels own you, you can't let corporations own you, you can't let anyone own you but God.
Chantam tempura filho em coro.